Hi, I'm Laura from PokerNews, and I'm back with Gershon Distenfeld. For anyone that doesn't know his story, I'll link that video below. You won the 1500 shootout earlier in the series, and now you're back to pick up your bracelet. What does the ceremony mean to you?
It's something I always dreamed of. You know, for years I'd watch the ceremony and be like, wow, would it just be great to win a bracelet? But it'll never happen. And I still wake up some mornings and like, did this really happen? Was it a dream? So really, I'm just so fortunate, really a dream come true.
And now that you actually have the bracelet on your wrist, it probably feels more real.
Yeah, it's surreal. You know, people ask me why it took 2 weeks, because I had to leave the next day after I won the event, and Jack wouldn't let me take the bracelet without doing a bracelet ceremony. He's afraid I wouldn't come back. But it's great to have. I'm very, very excited about it.
You headed home to your family right after the event. You're back now for the main. Did you do anything fun? Were you out celebrating with friends when you were back?
I had to go to work, but definitely, yeah, I went celebrating with friends, with colleagues. A lot of excitement. People have just been great. A lot of people, I was playing the main event yesterday. Fortunately, I busted out in day one, but there's people at the table recognized who I was, and they were thanking me for everything I've done. People have just been wonderful.
And you played the main yesterday. Are you playing anything else, or are you done for the year?
Yeah, I'll be playing a couple more events this week. I typically only play a few events a year. Mm-hmm. This maybe was my 20th ever bracelet event. And so I'm just so fortunate to have won it.
And you had your speech there during the bracelet ceremony. Could you tell us again, for the people at home that didn't hear, what you were talking about?
Yeah, I was encouraging everyone to pledge to give away 1% of their poker winnings. I think we just are all so fortunate. We're playing a game we love. Mm-hmm. We all have, you know, the money, the time, the good health to play. And I just think it's the least we can do if we run deep in a tournament, make a final table, win a bracelet, is to give back to those less fortunate. So whatever charity speaks to someone. So I actually asked Jeff Platt, who does all the interviews, I asked him, you know, to when people start winning some big money, to ask them if they'll take the 1% pledge. I'd love to see it become a thing, that people feel an obligation almost, and they should, to give back a little bit to when they have good fortune. Mm-hmm.
Did you talk to Jeff? Jeff had a big win.
Jeff had a great, I was fortunate to be on his rail. He was, we joked how maybe, you know, the day before, how maybe we'd both be on a final table the same day, and we were. And yeah, he finished fourth, and unbelievable. I just told Jeff before, I got my one bracelet, I'm good. He can win the next one.
Next is for Jeff. And he did support with his winnings, I did hear that. So
I'm sure he did, he's a good man.
You're inspiring people already. Thanks so much for talking to us again, and I'll see you during the rest of the series.
Thank you so much.
That's all from me. I'm Laura from PokerNews. Our coverage of the WSOP is powered by ClubGG.